Hi guys, I am back with a new video and I am still a little bit emotional, but somebody asked me if I could look at her Bernese mountain dog. That's how they look like for the ones that have no idea. In the Netherlands they're called also known as a Bernersenner. And she wants to know if her dog suffered or not. I didn't prepare anything. I did a little bit of meditation, but that's it. So I'm going to slowly work my way through all the information her dog is ready to give me. Now I see a apartment building and you are not the one walking the dog. They are stepping outside, and these dogs have a typical very slow wobble. I'm not sure how to call it, but it's a very chill, relaxed wobble that is typical for this breed. And the one that's walking the dog is trying to encourage her, and what I smell is, I think it's liver. There is a little bit of this typical iron taste, and I am walking over the pavement and I see smell, which is weird because you have to smell a scent. So I am seeing all kinds of locations where the dog wants to sniff around, and these pieces of raw meat are in a red pouch, something synthetic. Chica never used snacks during a walk, so I'm not sure. I think my mom has this dried dog food in her pocket, but usually in her pants and not in a special pouch. But a Bernersenner is a big dog, so I think if you want to encourage and reward a Bernersenner, then you have to carry a lot more. The pouch is quite big. It has a leather string with a button to close it and to open it again, and there you go, wobbly, typical. And there is something with the legs. I feel a pain in my shoulders, which is really weird, but these dogs have, if you know them, if you've seen them walk, they have this, you know, very chill, relaxed movement, way of moving forward, and they like to sit down and drop down on the pavement, which he does. Then he gets another piece of liver, which isn't dried food, but as in real raw liver. This pain in the shoulders is weird. I feel this pain in the shoulders while the dog is moving forward, walking, and it wants to sit down all the time to relax his front paws. Now I think the right paw is a little bit longer than the left paw, which causes an imbalance in his movement. So let me just do a little bit of healing on the shoulder area, because it's hard to, it just sticks to the dog even when, while it's gone, he died. That's why you want to know whether or not he suffered. So just now I can do two things with the dog except for healing the shoulder area. It's in between the shoulder blades, so that's and it has to do, it doesn't come from the shoulders, it has to do with the right leg being a little bit longer than the left leg. I can just make the right leg a little bit shorter and the left leg a little bit, I don't know. I think I will just, the right leg is a little bit longer and the difference in height in the two legs causes the pain in the shoulder. So you might have noticed that your dog is very sensitive. You can scratch his back and massage his neck, but the shoulder area is something that I think this dog isn't too happy with. So I am trying to bring back a little bit ba of balance in the legs so they have the same height and they support your dog a little bit better. So it's easier for your dog to move and walk and go a little bit faster. And now they go around the corner. Okay, legs steady, steady on the floor. There's more. Okay, are you okay? Feels better. And the elbows. He's heavy, right? I think he's a little bit overweight. I know Benner Setter dogs are big and heavy, but he got a lot of snacks. I think raw meat was the best choice because it's low in fat most of the time. So that's a good thing. Okay, it's looking at me. And they go around the corner, and I think it's your dad who's walking him because you are doing your job, you are at work, and your dad is walking him. Not sure if he walks your dog every day, but there's a nice connection between the two of them, and your dad isn't supposed to let go of the leash, which he does on purpose. Because he trusts your dog to not run off and move away and go crazy. Now I enter a field and there are a lot of, it's infested with dandelions. And I think your dog lost bees and flies and all kinds of bugs, and I'm still seeing where he smells, which is kind of great. And then there is a German Shepherd, which he hates a lot. This is a lot of friction between the Berner Senner and the German Shepherd. So, or yours a female, that's a male, and they, I think the German Shepherd is too proactive and aggressive, and he looks like he wants to play, but it's alert, very, very alert, very sharp. So for a Berner Senner, that might be a little bit too much, and he wants to be left alone. There's a little white dog that comes running towards your dog and runs off. And then your dad's still there, your dog's in the field, a lot of dandelions. The threat of that German Shepherd is gone, they went that way. And then I see a street, and on the other side of the street, there is a Golden Retriever or a blonde Labrador, and your dog really wants to play with this dog. It's also a female. I think yours a female. You didn't tell, but that Labrador, I think, is very attractive, as in not as in sexual, but is in, you know, just they want to meet. And it's sitting behind the front door looking through the window, and your dog goes across the street jumping for a Berner Sennar mountain dog. It's not really jumping, but wobbly and happy, and your dad screaming. And then I see a black car. I hear a car, and it's black. And your dad's calling your dog, and then he turns around, comes back, and gets hit. I see him lay on there he is on the street, on his left side. And your dad is silent, as in shock, as in he's not crying, he's not screaming, he is there on his knees with the dog, your dog, and it's already gone. So let me see what's going on. The Labrador is barking, and the black car is gone. What's going on there? If you hit a big dog like that, you can't just be gone, right? There's no owner, there's nothing, there's just your dad and the dog. I am going through this from your dog's point of view, so. And then you stand up out of your body, and there you go. Back to that field with all those dandelions. Which is kind of funny. I don't know if he realizes that he is hit by a car, but physically, he's gone and he didn't suffer. I am absolutely no for sure. I don't even hear or feel the hit or the crash or whatever. I can. He stood up out of his body and went to that dandelion thing. And you have a little bit of a or a lot of difficulties with connecting to your dog. Now he's gone, and that's because he hates your bird. Do you have a bird, like something green sitting on a, I think it's a painting or a piece of art that hangs on the wall. I don't know what's on it, but there's a bird, green, and it's looking at your dog's bed. So there, your dad is filled with guilt, and your dad doesn't want to visit you anymore because he doesn't know how to apologize or how to make things right. And you can send him messages like, I forgive you, but that means this was, I think, 3 years ago, not two, not four, three years ago. And I think it's 3 years ago, but that's from the point of view from your dog again. So your dad doesn't want to come over anymore, and you can send him messages like, I forgive you, but that means that you are forgiving him, working on, busy with doing, forgiving him. I think it's best to send him messages that you forgave him. Then it's clear and settled and ready, and I think he will come around if you send him these messages. It's just a telepathic type of sending love and light and letting your dad know that he is forgiven, that you forgave him. Because I really think that you miss your dog and you still want him to know how he is and how he's doing, but you want your dad back. So it would be good if you took your dad to the place where this happened, or if your dad is ready, your dad would take you to the place where it happened, because he knows exactly what happens and where it happened, I think. I know. So there you are with a dog spirit animal that refuses to come home, which is sad. And you still have the dog bed, and you still have his bowl and his favorite. Is it rubber or some kind of plastic? It's not a real bone, it's a fake bone. It's red, I think. But he hates the bird, and you can't just get rid of the bird because, I don't know, you still have to take... It's another pet, another animal. But I don't think this is a familiar. It's just a beautiful bird. And so what your dog does during the day is wobble around and make the German Shepherd nervous, because he knows he can approach the German Shepherd without the German Shepherd go all crazy on him. So he's smart. He can just freak out the German Shepherd. And I think if you look out of the window and you see the German Shepherd, you know that he will be jumpy and nervous and anxious and looking over his shoulder. And we might want to do something about that. Maybe do a little bit of healing between them, or maybe you're just enjoying it when you see it. Maybe if you have already seen it, but that's how it looks to me. But and your Bernard Sanner is outside the apartment building, wobbling around during the day and sitting on his behind, looking up at your apartment. And it's a Bernese mountain dog. These dogs are so relaxed and so, I don't know, relaxed. It's the same with the Beagle. I have never met a Bernese mountain dog or a Beagle that were aggressive or something. So totally chill. He's not hunting, he's not nervous, he is not experiencing any type of pain except for the pain in his shoulders. If the pain in his shoulders, I will do another healing on it. I think it's getting better. It's just between the shoulder blades, it's achy. And like I said, you've probably noticed that he's sensitive there. It doesn't have to do anything with weakness in his shoulders, but it's the shoulders that want to balance the different in height in the right leg and the left leg. It's maybe a centimeter or something. I wonder if you ever went to the vet with him, but we can do healings. Just, you know how your dog feels. I think you remember how he feels, and then you just, if this is the back, you place your hands just a little bit above it, and you just picture your dog in your mind exactly the way you remember it, and he's sitting with his back towards you, and you just gently place your hands a little bit above the place where it hurts, between the shoulder blades. And then you go to the elbows, and then you support the legs and bring back balance between the both paws. Just be gentle and careful, and send light into it. If you have no idea how to do this, I just can do both things. Do a reading, read, and give a healing. But And when you're done, then you put your one hand over his chest bone and the other hand on top of the place where it hurts, and you heal, and you gently put him down on his behind again so his shoulders can relax. So for now, this is it, and see you next time. Bye.